love what you're saying, because I think that we all have this idea of what Hollywood wants from us, whether it's from the hosting side, the acting side, the writing side, right, the direct, any aspect of it. We all think, just in life in general, we have an idea of what people expect or what people want. And we try to become that, and it's false in a sense, you know. It's
That's
when
true,
we
yeah.
truly acknowledge and accept, this is what I have to offer, uniquely what I have to offer, and I'm going to just be proud of that. That's when you start to get that notice, because people can recognize.
And it's unique.
Yes.
And it's personal, and it's not something they've seen.
Because it's not something anyone else can offer.
Exactly.
You know, it's
exactly.
something only you can offer, which, so I'm so grateful that you brought that up, because that is paramount.
Yeah, well, that was the thing I doing those. Any script you write is going to be hopefully educational for you and help build your craft, but yeah, it was putting aside those thoughts of pleasing people that is what really broke it through, for sure.
Yeah, I mean, you're a clear example of that being the truth, you know, so I think that that's really important to remind people.
And for sure.
So I guess the final kind of wrap-up question here, outside of just any advice you might have, but I'm curious, the difference now that you're a working writer, you're in the room, you're doing your thing as a professional, what's kind of the difference between that process on a daily basis versus when you're still a new writer and maybe you've gotten a break but you're not to this level yet? You know, what are the differences in your day-to-day?
That's a good question. It's a weird thing where there's pros and cons to each. So if you're a new writer or you don't have an agent yet and you are kind of, if you have the luxury to have huge hours of time during the day to write, or if you do it in the afternoon or evening, and you don't have studio executives telling you what to do, or you don't have that sort of interference, you have a great freedom of exploration and you can do things that are unexpected and interesting. The flip side, and I fell into this trap, and a lot of my friends now who are still struggling writers are in this situation where you have almost too much free time, and I found that there often would, like, a malaise would sort of set in.
Yeah, there's an unfocused.
Exactly, and you can always write the next day, you can always research a project forever before actually writing it. So, in a weird way, I wish I could tap into a part of that now, and I try to, because now I have deadlines, and I have meetings, and that's all great, and it a deadline is the greatest thing in the world because you have to finish at a certain time. But what I consciously try to do is to tap into that pure, I mean, it's almost like childlike, like that pure imagination, pure, I could do anything I want, just to remain excited about the stuff. So there's pros and cons to both, but you're definitely more regimented. There's more opinions in the room, but the trick really is, as much as possible, to tap into that pure freedom of imagination.
Finding the balance between having that freedom and having that structure and marrying the two together, that's where the success happens, I think.
Yeah, and so for a new writer, a writer that doesn't have representation yet, the trick would be, how do you do the opposite, which is you have that pure imagination, but how do you regiment yourself, either self-imposed or using contest deadlines or whatever it is, that can be incredibly helpful. Otherwise you can fall into that malaise, I feel.
Yeah, I completely agree. I think structure is very important. So again, thank you so much for bringing that up
because
I think that's something that, you know, definitely can help the viewers, is really find a way to implement more structure and put some deadlines on yourself. It will encourage that momentum. So thank you so much again for your time.
Sure.
And we are with Scripts and Scribes.